Hey, Remote Pilot 101, Jason here, bringing you another unmanned aircraft systems update. Listen, if you haven't passed your Part 107 test or have a recurrent test coming up, Remote Pilot 101 is where you need to be. No one has helped more remote pilots become certificated or recurrent than Remote Pilot 101. So today I'd like to give you an update. This is the latest from the FAA on how the tests are to be administered, as well as a few kind of changes to the FAA that I really believe you should know about. First, a bit of background. Now, when you go to take your test, you're in the hands of a company called PSI. They're actually good friends of ours. Every year at InterDrone, we have a booth right next to them as well. Now, they're contracted by the FAA to administer all airmen tests. This is not just Part 107. So you could be sitting next to someone who's taking the private pilot exam or their airline transport pilot exam, just as an example. So PSI Services, they're actually based in Glendale, California, and they received their awarded contract to administer all testing back in 2018. However, it's taken a couple of years to get up to speed. So now, PSI is actually fully established within more than 800 testing centers throughout the United States. So if you want to register for your Part 107, just general initial exam, you go to the PSI website, that's psiexams.com, you create your account, you look for your testing locations around the country, sign up, you pay your testing costs. It's usually, or used to be, we'll say $150. It's up to $160 now. Interestingly enough, the FAA does not pay PSI to conduct these testings. So PSI makes all that money directly from these registration fees. Now, remember that this company, PSI, administers exams in many areas, not just for the FAA. So when you see the drop-down menu for what kind of entity, choose government, and then FAA, and then unmanned general. Unless you're taking the two-year renewal, instead you should choose recurrent here. So now that things are pretty well up and running for PSI, the FAA has announced some, we'll call them modifications to the testing procedures that take effect January 13th, 2020. The most important change is that anyone registering to take an FAA exam must get what's called an FAA Tracking Number, or FTN. You must do this first. So how is this different than what you did before? Well, up to now, you didn't apply for an FTN until after you passed the test. So when you registered to take your test, PSI assigned you an administrative testing ID number. Remember, it's the super, super long, way too many numbers and everything else, right? The FAA figured, well, if it's too many numbers, it could get confusing. So in an effort to be more efficient, the FAA is saying that starting January 13th, you must apply for an FTN number first before registering for your test. So now, where do we apply for this FTN? Well, we do that at the FAA's IACRA webpage. So for those of you who have not been to IACRA site, by the way, it stands for Integrated Airmen Certification and Rating Application. It's basically the FAA's webpage for pilot applications. So here's what we do. We go to iacra.faa.gov. Don't choose a username yet. Choose Register. Agree to the terms of service. For those of you who hold an airman certification already, you have an FTN number. You enter that and the system finds you. If not, fill in the personal info, include email and security questions. We create our username and our password. We then click the register button and we get our FTN. You will need to know this number to sign up for your knowledge test, so keep it somewhere safe. Some other provisions in this January 13th, 2020 update by the FAA include the removal of the seal on the test results document. That means they just, you know, they use that stamp to kind of seal the document. They're not going to do that anymore, no big deal. Just in case you read about it, you understand actually what it means. And the addition now of ACS codes for the missed questions. This is what that really means to you. You're going to get a list of codes for the questions that you missed so that you can go look them up online later and see what areas you need to study up on, or maybe take the test again if need be, just for your own edification if you want to. Interestingly enough, though, they don't give you the exact questions that you missed, only the knowledge category. So that's probably because they don't want you to have the actual test questions and those get revealed to the public. But at least you'll know the questions you missed were in this given subject area, for example, density altitude or weight and balance. So what we can do, we can go to psiexams.com or we can give them a ring on their phone as well. So I have that listed there for you. Listen, the industry, by the way, is full of acronyms. So before I leave you, I want to fill you in on just one more acronym. It's ACTS, Airman Certificate Testing Center. That's the job that was awarded to PSI to manage and facilitate all FAA knowledge testing. We also learned about FTN, that's the FAA tracking number. That's the number you must apply for ahead of time before registering for your test. Then we have IACRA, Integrated Airman Certification and Rating Application. That's the webpage we go to, well, to get our FTN. AKTS, Airman Knowledge Testing Supplement. You'll see that one a lot. That's the booklet. It costs $8 on Amazon or the PSI website. They have it there. There's PDFs available as well. PSI is going to provide you with a copy of the booklet to use while you're taking the test. But you might want to order your own so you have it while you're going through the Remote Pilot 101 course as well. We have it as a PDF as well for you. Now, when you go to take your tests, they're not going to let you bring your phone in. You got to put everything in a locker so nothing goes into the testing room with you, with the exception of I can bring in my basic calculator, a magnifying glass, or whatever it is. But they're going to have pencil, paper there for you. They'll have a copy of that AKTS, that knowledge supplement book there as well. You have 2 hours to answer 60 questions, which sounds like a lot, but I promise it's plenty of time. So there you have it, an update on how to take your Part 107 knowledge test. I want to thank you for checking this out, and thank you for making Remote Pilot 101 the most popular and successful Part 107 test prep course on the market. We'll see you. Remote Pilot 101 is the most successful Part 107 test prep course on the market, with over 18,000 tests passed. It's one price, and you get our updated initial and brand new recurrent course for life. It's two courses for the price of one, and it's for life. See the actual test questions, learn the material, take the practice quizzes, all at your own pace through our easy videos you've already grown to love. Visit RemotePilot101.com to become a member for life and learn more.